Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, we'll learn how to configure a lazy loaded route. So let's get it started now. I have just installed a fresh copy of the Angular application. It has pretty bare minimum design. On the header, we have two links. My idea here is the first link will eagerly load the component defined under app.module. And the other link will lazily load a feature module. So let me add some route config here. We need path. Let me give this a name regular. And then we need to define a component. So we are trying to add a route config for the eagerly loaded module, right? Which is app.module. So let me create a component. We can create a new component using Angular CLI. I'll name this as regular. It will create a new folder here. It has HTML, CSS, and this component file. And also, this CLI will add this component as part of the main app.module. And we just need to link that component here. Let me now run the application. So when I click on this link, we can see this text here. And this text is coming from this file here. So now let me add the route config for lazily loading a feature module. So before doing that, we need to create a feature module. Let me copy and paste this command here. I have here with me. Let me clear this terminal. And then here I'm trying to generate a new module called lazy loading. And then it will have route as lazy loading. And this lazy loading module will be registered under app module as well. So basically we'll be seeing one more config which will be added by this component. Sorry, this CLI command. As I mentioned earlier, we now have a new config which represents a lazily loaded feature module under routes array. If you look closely, the way we define a route config for a lazily loaded feature module differs from the route config of defining a component. So please make sure that you define loadChildren method for lazily loaded module. And this method actually returns a promise. And if we look here on the lazy loading module, we have this module file here, and then it also needs to have its own routing module, which is right here. So there might be scenarios where your feature module might have many other components. So in that case, we'll have many route config. But in our use case, we'll just define an empty path, and that will load this component, which is right here. And it has this text, which is lazy loading works. Let me now start the server, and then we'll check by clicking this route. So the moment of the truth. So there you go. So we can see this text here. So if we go and inspect on the network tab here, we'll see some difference between regular route and lazy loaded routes. So let me go on the network. Let me first go on the regular route. It make requests to all these bundles right here. We have five bundles here. But if we go on the lazily loaded route, we'll see one more extra bundle here, this one. So this this represents that this chunk is this module here, right? And this is loaded on demand. That's pretty much it for this video. I hope this helps. Thank you very much for watching my video.